Good evening. I didn't plan on being on this late. I just got back from doing my deliveries about maybe 20 minutes ago, and I have a breaking news report that just came out that I wanted to share with you guys. First, the good news. John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that he who believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. He who believeth in him. Thief on the cross. Thief on the cross. Perfect example. He was a thief. He believed. Now, that does not give us a green light to sin. We don't want to sin. We live for Christ. If you've stumbled, do not let Satan put those thoughts into your head that you're not forgiven, because that's a lie from the devil. Devil knows his time's just about up. He is attacking us left and right. But you know what? He's defeated. He can't win. He's a loser. He was defeated at the cross. When you accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, your sins are washed clean. And you are rapture ready. God sees it. Best way to put it is one thief on the cross. Our Heavenly Father loves us so much, he sent his only begotten Son as a sacrifice for our sins. And he sees our heart. God sees everybody's heart. There is a preacher of rapture. Revelation 3 verse 10 is the clearest indicator of that. God does not show favoritism. All throughout the Bible, those deemed worthy escaped God's wrath. We are the bride of Christ. God's not going to show favoritism. Say, well, I'm going to save them, but I'm going to make you go through hell. You're the bride of Christ. Your sins have been washed clean, but I'm going to make you endure hell. We don't meet the Lord in the air, grab a horse, and come back down. When's the marriage supper? Rapture is going to happen very soon. Whatever you're going through, hang in there, because we're all meeting at the marriage supper. And remember, God gives his toughest battles to his strongest soldiers. Satan isn't going to focus too much on the ones he already has. He already has them. Doesn't have to worry about them. He already has them. He isn't going to focus on the ones he doesn't have. Whatever you're going through, if you're struggling, a lot of us are struggling today. Just remember, you got brothers and sisters in Christ that love you. We're all going to be meeting very soon. We're all meeting at the marriage supper. And all of this is going to be over soon. We are in the home stretch. RT is reporting breaking news that Hamas has fired rockets at Israel IDF. Projectiles were launched. Okay, I can't remember. Did I say this was from RT? I'm sorry. I've been driving for like 6 hours and I'm going through menopause and my memory stinks. Sometimes if I have to repeat myself, that's why. Projectiles were launched at southern and central parts of the country on Saturday morning. Militants, so this is like literally just happened. Militants have launched rockets from Gaza into southern and central Israel on Saturday morning. The IDF said at least one person was reported dead. Hamas carried out a combined operation involving rocket fire and infiltrations by terrorists into Israeli territory, the IDF said in a statement. The Megan David Adom Ambulance Service said that one person was killed by direct rocket impact and 15 more were wounded. So, if there's any more breaking news, I will be back on and let you guys know. I need time to wind down before I go to bed. I'm in Central Time in the United States. It's 12:30. So, I'll probably maybe about 1:30 get to sleep. So if there's any more breaking news before then, I will be back on. If not, I'll be back on tomorrow. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. God bless you. Keep looking up. We're going home. God bless.